So, Bakken is the world's oldest amusement park. It's a place full of attractions and charm, and it is by far the most Danish amusement park I have been to. This place is packed with Danish culture, from the food to the overall atmosphere, and when it comes to rides, some of them really make this park feel like a stationary version of a traveling fun fair. Bakken has an amazing classic feel and fun for the entire family, which includes a total of 6 roller coasters, which I will be ranking from worst to best today. These 6 coasters are a mix of classic and experimental, and starting off the list at number 6 is Mariehøn, a small standard Sierra Tivoli coaster. This ride is very much meant for the small kids. It doesn't feature much of a thrill, and it's really only there so that small children also have a coaster to ride. One thing it does have going for it, however, is charm and nostalgia. I remember loving this ride as a kid, and today those memories have stuck with me. In fact, I still grab a ride on most of my visits because Bakken never really has long queue lines anyway. It's nicely located in between greenery, as well as one of the world's smallest Ferris wheels. And one thing that actually makes this coaster special is that it has a waving brake. It runs 4 cycles, and after the first 2, it halts on the lift hill so that the kids can wave at their parents. It's pretty cool. So I like Mariehøn. It is the least thrilling coaster at the park, but it has my thumbs up. Number 5 is Racing, which is a classic Sierra Flitzer. This is kinda Sierra's answer to a bobsled roller coaster. It's stuck to the track, but you sit in these cars with no restraint whatsoever, holding onto the side of the vehicle. The layout only consists of a bunch of compact turns and drops, and the train vibrates like crazy, but I would still call this a fun ride. Because of the way you're sitting, many of the drops feel faster, and the ride has a great classic feel to it. The layout is also very compact and goes around itself plenty of times, and when you consider the many block brakes, which by the way don't slow you down at all, you will see a bunch of cars going around the course at the same time, and if you and a couple of friends are riding in separate cars, it actually has a bit of race feel to it as you pass them several times during the ride. Overall, I always have my share of fun on Racing. It's not intense or smooth, but not every ride needs to be that for a good experience. Number 4 is very controversial. This is Tornado. Now, first of all, don't take this spot too personal, because this ride has jumped up and down my list quite a lot, and it will likely be at a different spot again one day. In fact, Tornado was my number 2 coaster at the park for a long time, and for a short month or so this year, it was even my number 1. Let me explain. As of 2019, this is the world's only intamin spinning coaster, as well as the most intense roller coaster in all of Denmark. It features a dual-chain hydraulic launched lift hill, which throws you into what I believe is the most intense first drop on any roller coaster in the world, period. This drop is absolutely insane and feels like a car crash, as my good friend Villa Spurn describes it as, and it gives the biggest rush of adrenaline I have ever experienced on a roller coaster. It's some of the most powerful lateral and ejector airtime I've ever felt. Furthermore, the coaster also hits 5Gs and is simply a monster despite its size. So why is it only my number 4, and why was it higher before? Well, sometimes this ride can give incredible smooth rides, which are intense and enjoyable. But depending on the car spinning, I find most of my rides on it to be very rough, painful, and straight up unpleasant to ride. When it was my number 1, I had just visited where I got more than one smooth ride with no hard spinning, which I tend to prefer. But on my latter visits this year, I have gotten way more terrible rides, and I have therefore put it at number 4, simply because I find myself go for re-rides on the coasters in my top 3 instead of re-rides on this one. But I always give it a chance when I visit in hope of one of those rare, amazing rides. Number 3 is Rutschebanen, the park's most iconic coaster, a scenic railway from Danish designer Valdemar Lebec, built in 1932. This is the second oldest wooden coaster I've ridden, and it is a true classic. It stands right in the middle of the park and adds massively to the park's atmosphere. This is actually one of those old woodies that used to not have any upstuck wheels on the train, meaning that it used to have a brakeman. However, in 2010, the old trains were replaced by new ones from Kumbach, which are the only trains I have personally ridden it with. The ride features a bunch of big drops and hills, however, it has a massive downside. The coaster features a bunch of trim brakes doing its turnarounds, which results in no airtime on pretty much every hill, except for a single one, which gives some floater airtime in the very front row. The ride does feature two double downs, both of which give great airtime, however it's very short on both of them, and another massive downside also makes them worse. The restraints. The trains from Kumbach feature restraints that glide down during the entire ride, and when you consider the ride's roughness, they fall down even faster. And doing those double downs, they really smash up your stomach. So why is this in the top 3, you might ask? Because it's still fun. Every drop is fun in that they all give a sense of speed, and I still do enjoy the double downs for the quick pop of airtime. I also just love the classic feel of the coaster. It feels very old, and I love that. When it comes to the coaster itself, there isn't actually a whole lot of positive things to say, but for some reason, I'm just always drawn back to it, and I still really enjoy my rides on it. Another thing is that I actually find the roughness fun a lot of times, so that's really just a bonus, and if you ask me, the best way to ride Hochebane is by riding with friends and family. At number 2 is something most people wouldn't expect, a mock ride Wilde Maus called Die Wilde Maus, which actually translates to the Wild Mice. Now, some of you might be thinking, how can you put a Wild Mouse above Denmark's most intense coaster, and a coaster with two double downs? Elementary, dear viewer. I simply find myself more attracted to this ride. I personally have a lot of fun on it. First off, the trains feature the comfortable lap bars from Mack rides, and overall, the ride has nice and smooth transitions. Second off, this coaster actually gives a pretty decent thrill. The iconic switchbacks give some good fun laterals that will make you feel like you're about to fall out. They're not as strong as on a Gerstler or bobsled, but Die Wilde Maus definitely has better laterals than some other Mack Wild Mouse coasters I've ridden. The coaster does feature the standard, compact Wild Mouse layout, so you're also going to find the same drops and bunny hops, which I personally really enjoy. In fact, I would say that every drop and hop gives a bit of airtime, and my favorite part of the ride is definitely the transition into the biggest drop. This turn is fast and whips you into a sharp drop, giving you a great minor moment of intensity. The ride also has many near-miss elements in form of supports, and overall, I always have fun on this Wild Mouse, and it's definitely one of my favorites. To be honest, I don't really have anything bad to say about it, so great job to Mack Rides. Finally, my favorite coaster at Bakken is Mein Train Ulven, an intimate family coaster. Besides from that 1 month Tornado was my number one, this has always been my favorite roller coaster at the park. On the outside, it might not look like much, but this ride definitely packs a good punch. To start off with, this ride has great lap bars, which are just big bus bars that don't touch me at all. This can be combined with my favorite part of the ride, the first drop. Even though it's a family coaster, it has an incredible first drop. In the front, you'll experience what feels like dangerous hang time, since you have so much room in your seat. And in the back, you'll get incredible airtime as you're flung into a sharp and steep angle very suddenly, which also gives laterals due to a slight change in direction at the top. The first drop is simply amazing, and it's followed by an incredible head-chopping tunnel and a great layout. The ride's course consists of a bunch of turns and helixes, however on a good day you'll get some good forces and feel some good speed. Not to mention some amazing near-miss elements. You see, this coaster is located in a bunch of greenery, and the train gets really close to it. In fact, I'd recommend not reaching your arms out too far, because you will hit trees. The great scenery helps a lot with the fun factor, but the coaster itself is simply a great family coaster with a good layout and an astounding first drop, and the ride is a true nostalgic treasure from my childhood as well. Before finishing the video, I'd also like to add a bonus spot, because even though Ulven is my favorite coaster at the park, it's not actually my favorite general ride there. That title goes to Tårngysel, which is an SNS double shut tower. This drop tower doesn't go very high up, but it features a fun launch which throws you into a crazy intense ejector airtime moment twice, and it's definitely the ride I have the most fun on in the park. Anyway, that's been it for my top 6 coasters at the world's oldest amusement park, Bakken. Let me know what you think of it, and whether or not you have a list of your own. Also, if you want to see more videos like countdowns, you are more than welcome to subscribe and follow my future content. Otherwise, it has been Northern Rides, and I hope you all keep on riding.